Hey there, today we are going hands-on to explore the fan-in and fan-out patterns using Go channels, a powerful way to handle concurrent data processing. Let's first create a producer function. This function will generate data and send it to a channel. Here's how it looks. Notice the close function at the end. This ensures that the channel is properly closed after all data is sent. Next, let's write the fan-in function to combine data from multiple channels into a single channel. Here, we are using range to read from the input channels and writing to a single output channel. Finally, let's tie it all together in the main function. Notice how fan-in helps us merge the data streams into one, making it easier to process the aggregated data. Let's now move to the fan-out pattern. First, we need a worker function to process data from a single channel. In the main function, we'll create a jobs channel and distribute tasks to multiple workers. This is the essence of fan-out. A single channel distributing tasks to multiple workers running concurrently. With fan-in, we aggregated data streams effortlessly. And with fan-out, we distributed tasks among multiple workers. These patterns demonstrate the power of Go's concurrency model. Try experimenting with different numbers of producers, workers, or data to see how the patterns add up to your needs.